Welcome to Hoops High, Chicago's leader in youth-produced sports broadcasting and youth media education. Hoops High is produced by high school students learning the skills of professional broadcasting. Hoops High is the flagship program of Free Spirit Media and is made possible in partnership with After School Matters, the Chicago Public Schools, and Chicago Access Network Television. We hope you enjoy the show.
Hi, my name is Jimmy Love. We're here at the Collins campus where we have the North Lyndale Phoenix versus the New Wallace Hornets. And for the looks of them, there's some big boys out there, so it's going to be a pretty good game. So stay tuned. You're watching Hoops High.
Introducing the starting lineup for your Hoops High. Y'all ain't ready. Fly boy.
Uh-oh, it's the H double. And all you other high school sports shows in trouble. The state champs is back. I hope they stay humble, cause the trophy is a must. And all the teams for you 100% game, 100% practice. No GPS needed, because greatness is trackless. You can try to take it, but you can never have it. Physically examine shows, show you what you lack.
Yeah,
yeah. You just tune in to the greatest on the west side, south side, north side, Hoops High. Yeah, every run be a shot. That's why you can catch us on TV now. KTV, channel 19, every Saturday, 8 o'clock. Y'all already know, prime time. How the supers get put on the camera, the youngest in the game. Y'all know y'all can't handle us.
Hoops High, Hoops High, Hoops High. Hoops High, Hoops High, Hoops High. Kenny D, boy. Production, Smash Brothers Entertainment, man.
Yo, ladies and gentlemen, welcome tonight. We have a big game lineup, North Lyndale versus Lew Wallace of Indiana, North Lyndale, Chicago, two powerhouses in both states. Big game. It's Mark Keel on the side with my main man,
Ralph Morales.
That's right. And hope y'all ready for this game. You're watching these highlights on the channel 19 every Saturday at 8. We catch the hottest hoops action around Chicago as we get ready to jump the ball off.
The pass, Brandon.
No.
Ralph is color.
Okay, out of bounds, ladies and gentlemen. Love my deal, Mark. We're going down. Jones. Smith. Smith Jones.
Wallace, man to man defense.
That's right. Jones for the tray ball. You hear the crowd was anticipated that to fall. Didn't fall out of bounds. Wallace ball.
Hey man, you and Bobby?
That pass.
Right. To the possession of Lyndale. Shot is up. It's good. 2 points. Down. Lew Wallace try to find some way to rebuttal. Get those points back. Long pass all the way to the corner. The shot is off. No good. Fight for the rebound underneath. And the three receiver the ball.
Oh.
Kicks it inside. A little fumble around there. Number five receiver, Jones. Out of bounds. North Lyndale will turn over the ball once again. What do you think of careless turnover so early in the game right now?
It's just bad communication. You just need to communicate early in the game. And you shouldn't be causing easy turnovers. The game has just started. Should be easy passes, communication should be on point, and it's not.
Right. The defense right there from North Lyndale forced Lew Wallace to that quick turnover. Ball going up. Ball going into the other direction.
Wallace now in the zone defense, switching it up, trying to confuse the offense.
Thorpe in the corner. Can you hear me?
Nope.
See, ladies and gentlemen, that three ball was good. Timeout will be called by Lew Wallace. And we're going to go to a quick commercial break, ladies and gentlemen. You are watching Hoops High.
Oh.
Joe Rock holding it down. And look, the only hoops I'm playing is with Hoops High, and that's what you're watching right now. See you later.
Yes, yes, and we are back coming out of a timeout.
So far, ladies and gentlemen, North Lawndale leads by 7. Start off the game right now. I mean, start off at the timeout. Lou Wallace receives the ball, running at a very fast pace. The shot is up, kind of forced. Like there's no control on Lou Wallace's behalf right now. North Lawndale gets the ball, going for that break that press.
Fast break. Oh, count it.
Two-hand layup is good for Jones.
Spits the defense. Nice pass.
Can also count that too, ladies and gentlemen. As Lou Wallace gets their first 2 points down. Ball is passed. Over the out of bounds.
Just a bad pass to pass it too far ahead. Inside.
Jones up with a three. No good. The tip is up. No good. The tip is back up. No good. They got out of bounds on Thorpe. Out of bounds. The ball will stay. We're going to possession of Lou Wallace.
North Lawndale playing very good coming in this first quarter. 9-2. Keeping Wallace underscoring them as much as they can.
That's right. Still a 7-point lead, ladies and gentlemen. Wallace penetrates, passed out to the 3-point line. No good. Wide open three, just couldn't fall for him that time. As Jones goes for the up and under, couldn't compete either. Man, number three from Wallace just moves up the court.
Ooh,
pass the ball, can't keep it. Easy.
Just a, can't hold on to the ball on the other end of the court, which leads to a fast break, 2 points.
That's right.
Coach has got to hate him.
Taylor with that layup is just phenomenal. Easy and laid it in. Nice quite softly, if I'm going to say myself. It's out of bounds right now. It's going to be Lou Wallace's ball.
Well, some red defense.
We got Taylor against Harris right now. Ooh, strong pick, wasn't it?
Yeah, Harris just passed right to the ref.
Just nonchalantly passing the ball around, getting it up the court.
Bounce pass.
Luana just can't keep their hands on the ball, man.
Butterfingers.
That's good.
Nice big man move.
Right. Big Maurice. The lay-in, Maurice Williams.
Oh. Can't hold on to the ball.
Moving down court. Man, moves right past his defender. I don't know if you want to call it a defender. The layup was missed, but the dunk was down by Williams with a wonderful finish. And we're going to go to another break, ladies and gentlemen. You are watching Hoops High.
Why am I being abused? Why is this happening to me?
I wish I never had you.
You know, don't nothing come easy. You got to try real, real hard. I tried hard, but I guess I got to try harder.
I try so hard, can't seem to get away from misery. Man, I try so.
Yes, yes, and we are back. Just tuning in, my name is Ralph Morales.
Mark Hill on the side.
North Lawndale on Wallace. 15-2, North Lawndale holds a great lead. That's early right. In this first quarter.
They got a nice dunk off. You know, a little flash along with the execution. And it's looking good for North Lawndale right now.
Wallace needs to just set out this first quarter in a good note and not in the bad note, because that could just lead right into the second quarter. You don't want that to happen.
Yeah, that definitely true. And I believe that's why the coach had called that timeout. You know, this quarter is pretty much over. You know, it's the first, only a minute 26 left right now. But the guys is definitely, like, the coaches on the side are trying to motivate the players back into the game because they're out so early right now. So we're going to get back to it as Lou Wallace gets ready to inbound the ball.
My Flindell man-to-man defense.
That's right. Attacking. Tight defense. What's up, man? The layup is up and no good. Big elbows thrown by Dawson down low. We have the ball passed to Jones. Jones with the far away three-pointer off the mark. We have Brown in the corner. Got trapped up right there.
Stops in the middle.
Pass to Harris. The floor general. Oh, and we have a hard foul by the big guy Williams down low. And that foul was on Williams. And the foul was gained by, I believe his name is Brown. Darren B. Brown. Darren Darius Dawkins Beezer. Damien, whatever the name is.
Brown at the line, shooting two. First one is good. Free throw is very, very big factor.
As you already know, ladies and gentlemen, we have discussed this issue multiple times on Hoops High. If you can't get the free throws, you can't really, you shouldn't be on our television. Let's just say it like that.
With that said, knocks down both free throws. I guess they just earned a spot on television.
That's right. On Chicago television. Now, I say being representatives of Indiana. That is laid down easy. 17-4 scores now stands as that 7-point lead has grown to a huge deficit of 13 now. 26 seconds on the clock.
Subs coming in for North Lyndale. Number 15. Jones.
Oh, hustle play, saved by Williams. Being pushed very strong and fast by number 15, Jones.
Puts it up, counts.
It's good with the last 12 seconds, still running on the clock. North Lyndale forces the ball up court, I thought. Pass to Dawson in the corner. Dawson moves, pass the ball to Lou Wallace's defender.
Last shot.
And the shot is good, a moving shot, no good. He got it off in time, but it just didn't fall. As you can see, he haven't completed the thing. Excuse me, I said the thing. He haven't completed as hoped for. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to toss it to the sideline. Jimmy Love, what's going on?
Hi, I'm here with one of the new Wallace players. What's your name, sir?
Jeremiah King.
Jeremiah King. And I saw you playing in the last game, so that means you're a freshman player, right?
Yep.
Freshman. So I saw you. I saw y'all kind of lost that game. So, are you confident that y'all gonna win the next two games? Cause we got two more games tonight.
Yeah, I got a lot of confidence in varsity and JV. JV down right now, but I think Coach Al will get them pumped up to come back out in the second quarter.
Oh, that's what's up. So I mean, do you feel that North Lyndale got a home court advantage, seeing that you know that y'all came all the way from Indiana? How you feel? You feel confident?
In our team, yeah, but I don't think home court advantage mattered to us.
Oh, so basically, y'all got North Lyndale, right?
JV and varsity do.
JV and varsity do, y'all. So we're going to take it back to the announcers. You're watching Hoops High.
Here in the center court, we are awaiting the inbound of North Lyndale right now. This game started off with the first 7 minutes on the clock. Second quarter, we're getting it right now. Inbound straight to Finley. Finley misses that layup attempt from Jones to Taylor. Taylor to Finley. Finley to Taylor.
Good defense by Wallace.
That's right. Staying with his man. Not going for the tricksters, dribbling and all that kind of things. And as you see, it got a turnover.
Ball is in Wallace possession. 17-6. North Lyndale's coming out in the second quarter, doing the same thing as they were doing in the first quarter. Hopefully Wallace can notice things that they are doing and kind of pick up on it.
That's right.
Use it to their advantage.
Uh-huh. Those small little, you know, flaws, pick up on it and just capitalize on them at all times. That's what North Lyndale's defense is best at doing.
Get ready to inbound it. Lyndale in the zone defense.
Right there, we had a foul on the play. I believe it was a reach in.
ladies and gentlemen, remember y'all watching Hoopside. You can watch Hoopside every Saturday at 8 CAN TV for all the hottest high school sports actions around.
Back tap by Philly was effective, just not good enough. As a tray ball is good by the big guy.
Number 11.
Yeah. Devoid.
Bad pass.
Oh, picked up the pass with ease, and the up and under is silky smooth by number 24, Johnson. Wonderful move. Talent is just plainly displayed for everyone to see on that play.
Trying to take his man.
I mean, a lot of dribbling. As you see, Taylor has a lot of skills and a lot of moves in his repertoire when it comes to dribbling. The up fake was wonderful by number 14, Hawkins. As the break. Oh. Bounce pass don't get completed or converted. Uh-oh. As Reese gets fouled, Maurice Williams going for that dunk. You see he stretched out his legs and his arms, but got fouled and couldn't complete the dunk as intended. Going to the line for 2 points.
Instant replay as you see it. Great up and under move.
Man, that was beautiful. Very smooth and well executed.
Read the pass on the other end of the court and just ended it with a fancy layup.
That's right.
First free throw was no good by Williams.
That's why I hate, ladies and gentlemen, this can make or break the North Lawndale team.
Yes, indeed, just because it's early in the second quarter. Like Mark just said, it can make you and break you.
That's right. I mean, you know, whatever you're doing in the beginning of the game will definitely affect you in the end. So you always want to come out and start just as hard as you finish, you know?
Exactly.
Out of bounds play again.
North Lawndale trying to trap him at half court.
Oh, and we got a blocking foul, which was a great call by the ref. Williams' feet was not planted, and he kind of flopped on that play. Great call by the referee going to the line for 2 shots. Foul will be on Williams.
I just see him just flop. Right.
Yeah, perfect way of seeing the two hoops out with the instant replay. I like that. Way to run it back and show the viewers.
It's number 11. Devoid goes up for his first free throw. Count it. Completes the 3-point play.
That's right.
Swings the ball inside.
Down low. Try to work that big man in the middle. With little big man, Hawkins. As you see, he's taking this guy head on. As we got the swift and nimble, number 24, Johnson again. Controlling the floor at his own pace, I must say. Pass to the mid-court line. Off the backboard, no good. Ball is retrieved by Williams.
Coach for Wallace telling the players, put your hands up.
Pass to Thorpe. It's the pick. Thorpe goes with his hands in his face. Couldn't get the ball down.
It's a bad shot. You know, the defense forced him into what they would like to force him into, and he just fell right into it.
Shot is up. No good. He had a nice look on that shot. Couldn't quite get it. Ball being pushed up the court right now by Jones. Pass to Jones. From Jones to Jones, ladies and gentlemen, just to clarify that. 4 minutes on the clock right now running.
Isolation play.
Whoa. Yeah, it was isolation. As you see, Lou Wallace had kind of identified that. They kept that big man down on the block. Closed it off, wasn't much of a threat, because that's the reason you call isolation, is to get your faster guy to the basket quicker than the guy that's defending him. So Lou Wallace did a great move on that one, catch that call.
Jones goes to the line, shooting two. First shot goes up.
Oh, he got an air ball on the free throw.
You would think just because he's a guard, his free throw percentage is higher than the rest of the team.
That's right.
He just air ball.
I mean, hey, it's the butterflies, the willies, whatever you want to call it. It's just not working.
Number 15.
Tell them they cut down our audio. There you go. Let's hunt the back down. Can't talk with no audio.
Check.
There we go, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry about that technical difficulty real quick. The audio was cut off, but we are still here, never leaving you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we know we are not always perfect, but we are working hard and we are always learning. We thank you for support and encouragement.
That's right. Beautiful viewers of Hoops High. Jones got the ball right now at the top. He's contemplating on shooting, but I guess he hesitated, got the drive. No good. Down low, the ball is knocked all around. The foul is drawn. Number 21, Grayson, will be going to the line for two shots. No, they turned the audio down. It was the audio board. You can hear it decreasing.
It's Grayson at the line. We're ready to shoot some free throws.
Know how we feel about free throws here at Hoops High, ladies and gentlemen. As that one is good. Makes me happy. Ralph's happy. Everyone's happy. 19-16. That 7-point, even 13-point deficit is now closed to a 3-point deficit. Lou Wallace is definitely bringing it back, as the freshman player said earlier in the interview. He had a lot of faith in his coach and the team, and there it goes. It just shows what it can do. As Dawson go up for the layup, can't get it. Wallace retrieves the ball.
Oh, loses it.
Saves it, passes it, loses it. The ball's on the floor. It's a fight. It's a fight, ladies and gentlemen, and it's a jump ball.
Great hustle by North Lyndale.
That's right.
Keep up with the ball, leaving on the floor.
And they will be getting the ball back for that hustle.
So North Lyndale gets ready to inbound it. Top of the key, swings it.
Wide open Jones, he's a shooter. Can't get it, though.
Wallace comes up with the rebound.
Man, the kid just weaves through traffic like crazy.
Oh, bad pass. As Wallace came out in the second quarter, Mark, and as I said earlier, hopefully they would have picked up on what North Lyndale was doing earlier in the first quarter, and it looks right. Like they did. I mean, 19-16 cut the lead to a very good margin.
That's right. I mean, these guys is excelling. I mean, they're more of like they're like players that conform to how the game is going. So if the game easy, they wouldn't have to change much. But if it's getting hard, then they know what to do, or they do what they make the necessary changes to, you know, bring the game back in their favor. And that's what Lou Wallace is all about, which is great. I mean, as a sophomore team too, that's even better. Even though you may come out in the beginning losing, you make those changes necessary to know what to do from the rest of the game on, if they can see it that early in the game.
Exactly. And as you mentioned, early in their sophomore year, hopefully when they get varsities, it'd be like common sense to them.
Exactly. So maybe the first couple plays, or, you know, first couple of minutes instead of, you know, the whole quarter. Definitely. Like, it's great to see growth and development within teams. See, the score now stands 20-16, 2:25 on the clock. Shot is off.
Taylor.
Yeah.
Officials getting everything organized. Free throws on the other end.
That's right.
Number 31.
They're in the bonus. As you can see, 7 fouls on North Lyndale.
Clark at the line.
And it's good. Make one. Make one, take one.
Second one is good.
It's good. Got a nice free throw shooter over there.
Cuts the lead to 20-18.
That's right. The game is getting tight, ladies and gentlemen. It's getting tight.
A little over 2 minutes left in the second quarter. Taylor.
Finley to Taylor. Taylor up with the shot. Short jumper. Nice fade. Just not good enough. The ball being pushed by the big man. 11 with the travel. The void.
Traveling violation called. Sees that often in this high school league.
That's right. Here we go again, switching the possessions over to North Lawndale right now.
Both teams making careless turnovers, looks like.
Oh,
big man.
Williams, the center, shoots the tray ball. You never see a lot of that, really, in high school basketball unless the coaches and the players are confident within themselves that the kid can shoot. So
he was feeling it.
Yeah, I really have. I'm pretty excited. I have a lot of excitement towards the next time he get better arc.
Shows good confidence.
Yeah, I want to see if he can light it up or not. Stop and pop.
No good.
No good. Rebound is retrieved. Quick up and under. Couldn't complete, though. It's number 31, Jones. I mean, Brown, excuse me. Oh, excuse me, not even Brown. Number 31, Clark. What was it, 32?
32, Phelps.
Oh. Is that Phelps? Like Michael Phelps?
Phelps at the line shooting too. First shot is good.
It's all good.
Second shot goes up. Getting ready to go up at least.
Uh-oh, I think we got a violation. We do.
Shooter.
He's going down. Put his foot on the line. You got to watch those toes at all times. Can cost you that point. You don't want that to happen. Once it costs you that point, then it's a wrap. As the ball is turned over by Jones. Get knocked up a little bit.
Clark.
That's right. Getting in the mix of the hole, you know, when you get in that paint. It's a lot of body contact.
Goes to the line. It's free throws. These free throws are very important to end the, well, getting ready to end the second quarter,
that's
first
right.
half.
That's right. These free throws can determine whether they had a lead
exactly.
or not in the end of this quarter. And it's good. First one falls.
Tied it up since the score was 0-0. First time.
Yep. Yeah, that's right. The first time since 0-0. This the chance right here to gain the first lead of the game for Lou Wallace.
Count it.
You can count it, ladies and gentlemen. Clark turned the tide of the game. And we have a new ball game. North Lawndale now trying to get. Oh, man, controls his body so well that he can finish that. That's a very well polished young man right there.
North Lawndale trying to trap him, but he's penetrating.
Oh, same team.
Swings it.
That's right. Shot is up at a big guy. I think it's a bad attempt because they are up right now. They just need to let the time run out and take the lead and the momentum with them.
Exactly. It's an instant replay. Controls his body.
Yeah, wonderful move right there. Jones is showing his athleticism in many ways. Man, long pass to Taylor. Taylor with the left-hand hook. No good, but you can definitely count on the big man Williams underneath the basket to make up for that. Another steal by Thorpe. Couldn't complete. Ball being pushed right now by Brown. I mean Johnson. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. Johnson. There's Brown.
Traveling.
Yeah.
I didn't.
Yeah. Didn't expect that, right?
Not at all. I mean, looks like a regular dribble to me. But they got them shirts on for a reason.
That's right. That's what happens.
Big Williams.
Williams, man, faded. Not quite the shot selection, I think.
Hustles for it.
Oh, that was a travel. No call. And you can count that. I think it was a tray ball. It was a tray ball. Shot is up. No good. Ladies and gentlemen, as we have two competitors right now. They're going at it. There's nothing right now I see going on wrong, you know, between these two teams. What about you, Ralph?
I mean, same thing here, Mark. North Lawndale just has to keep this lead and not let Wallace trail their way back in this game as 21-27 speaks for itself.
That's right.
With that said, we're going to toss it over to Jimmy, see what Jimmy got for us.
What's up?
Hi, I'm here with the North Lawndale principal, Dr. K. And, you know, we had a terrible incident with one of your students. So what kind of precautions did you guys take to make sure that everybody here was safe today?
Well, you know, one of the things we did right away was be in contact with the police district, make our concerns known. They've been really supportive about being present here tonight. But I think more importantly, we've been working with our kids to step them up to the plate and our players and our parents to say, look, real change comes from human beings helping human beings, not by force, but changing minds. So NLCP Way is to change minds and hearts, and that's what we're about. So you'll see a lot of teachers, administrators here tonight, parents, all of us coming together because we want our kids to be safe, and human beings are the way to make it happen.
Right. So do you have any words of encouragement, just quick words of encouragement to prevent this kind of behavior from any activities or anything?
You know, we tell our kids all the time, let the little stuff go, ignore the looks, ignore someone who says something to you. Step up, man up, walk away, get an adult to help you, but it's not worth someone getting shot or a fight starting. Peace is the way to go, and that's what we're about.
All right. So I appreciate it. Thanks. I really appreciate it.
Y'all need probable cause to search her.
What's up? This is Larry Hughes. You're watching Hoops High.
I'm a BLOOD. Been on songs with SNOOP. Inside a Ferrari with the DRE. One up, I let it sing like Nate D-O-double G. Walk through 8 miles, G units on my feet.
Wasted. Got a cherry low rider in the NYC. Feeling like I'm about to throw up. Been uptown with 56 niggas and tips. I didn't merge past, I put it. Where's the car?
I don't know. It was right here.
We just hit.
You just hit somebody, man.
What do you mean we hit somebody?
We were driving. I said stop.
We should have never got drunk.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's Mark Hill on side with my main man,
Ralph Morales.
That's right. And we're here once again at Collins Campus, North Lawndale of Chicago versus Lou Wallace of Indiana, ladies and gentlemen. The big clash of the Titans. State to state, neighbor and state's big things going down here, ladies and gentlemen, tonight. And since you can't be here, we will definitely bring it to you. Little fact right now, this is the only CPS game that's going on tonight. And, I mean, who wouldn't want to be here? So if you're not here, we're just going to give you all the excitement, all the people that's here, and everybody from Chicago, Indiana that's known, we'll be here tonight. So hope you're watching Hoops High. Got a traveling double dribble call, no traveling violation call. Let's say he's like cousin of the traveling violation calls. No double dribbling and traveling like go hand in hand.
They all family.
That's right. So, going to get it back. Lou Wallace bringing the ball down. As you see, the trap starts at half court for North Lawndale. They're not letting anything come down there. And the ball is passed continuously. If the shot is up by number 11, he's been shooting all day. No good. Rebound is retrieved by Brown. Brown puts it in. 2 points. If you just tuned in, they want to give people a quick rundown of what's going on right now. If they just turned into Hoops High, you know, and just watching and they don't know what's going on, you want to tell them what's going on?
Well, if you haven't been watching, first quarter was all North Lawndale's way. But it's 27-23. Obviously, it's not so much North Lawndale way.
That's right.
Second quarter, Wallace just picked up and noticing what North Lawndale was doing and led it to their advantage in 27-23, 5 minutes and 56 seconds.
That's right.
So, Lou Wallace – they doing a pretty good job, and defense has stepped up majorly exactly. since the first quarter.
Identified what they were doing wrong and just made it happen, you know, and put in, closed the patches that was in their game at the time. So I really give, you know, a lot of help, you know what I'm saying, helping hand to – I said helping hand. That don't make any sense. Cut. I'm going to give a little of my encouragement by me being a North Lawndale fan to Lou Wallace, because they can make this game even more exciting than what it is already. So go ahead, you know, make it a show for the people at home, for make those at Indiana proud and represent very well as they're already doing. As you just seen in the last interview, you know, it's a lot of things going on right now in Chicago as far as the violence and things that's going on. But North Lawndale's having to live very well today. The players, the teachers are here. A lot of fans from Lou Wallace are here. And we're just taking that whole history of violence and saying history is the past, and we're going to look forward to the future right now and just do everything the right way.
Exactly.
Get back to the game. Sorry for that, ladies and gentlemen. Jones with the drive. Dishes it off to Williams. Williams with a strong move to the basket. It's good. 29-24. North Lawndale now leads by 5. Ball is brought up by number 24, Johnson, in the corner stuck. Passes it right to Williams, trying to get out of the jam. The ball is thrown away. Right at the Hoops High crew, as you can see them right there in their little den, trying to hide from the falling balls. And if you're an avid Hoops High watcher, you know that we get terrorized by balls every game.
Man.
Somebody's always getting hit, and somebody's always, you know, just whizzing by their ears or something. So we scared of these balls out here, ladies and gentlemen. Y'all got to bear with us on this one.
Yeah, we got a very dangerous job. Even the announcers.
Even us. Like, we have plenty of times. Well, players will try to say the ball and crash into the whole table.
Exactly.
And then we just sit here and like, oh, man, we got to put it back. They be like, y'all okay? Yeah, we okay. I don't know if our equipment all right, though, but, you know, those small things, ladies and gentlemen. But we do it for you guys and us because we enjoy it. But you guys, you're the people. The audience is the boss. We work for y'all.
Fast break on the other end, 2-on-2.
It was a 2-on-2, right? Go ahead, man. Take it. Go ahead, Ralph, man. Take a little play-by-play for me, man. That's the least you can do for me.
Taylor,
there
top
we go.
Of the key.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Work it. Work it.
Swings it inside. Big Williams puts it up.
No good. Man, I love it, man. It just works so much better. Don't you agree, ladies and gentlemen? The people agree. Why would you let the people down? They look forward to hearing play-by-play from you every time. Why would you let them down, Ralph?
I look forward to a lot of things that don't happen.
Well, come on, man. You got to be an optimist.
But for this time, I can let it happen.
Gotta be an optimist, man.
Wallace swinging at top of the key. Inside, great pass. Count it. Great pass, bro.
Yeah, number passing, man. Harris. Lou Wallace is definitely identifying that pass and will get them through North Lawndale, you know, because North Lawndale is a pressing team. They will put the pressure on you at all times. So unless you got great passers and great decision makers on your team, you would not do anything against North Lawndale. As you see, you got the fast break. Oh, the big guy hangs. Can't complete. The strong rebound is received and laid back in by number 23.
Brown.
Lovely move.
Great. That was a nice rebound. I mean, took it right out of his opponent's hand.
That's right. As Dawson kicks it back out.
Taylor. Swings it inside to Big Williams.
Man, pull Williams up. With the pull-up. Easy.
Count it. Tim Duncan move.
Yeah, man. That was a wonderful move. Playmaker style. Create for himself. Once he create for himself, they'll start guarding him more. Then the team is able to score more. Wonderful move.
Harris carries the ball.
Carries. Picking that ball up. Got to be careful as the ref keeps signaling him with his hands exactly what he did and how he did it.
Think that was caused by the North Lawndale's defense.
That's right, man.
Trying to trap him at half.
Yep. They play a mind game more than a physical game.
Taylor.
Oh.
Lazy pass, but completes it. Penetrates number 5.
Jones.
Count it.
The easy drop. It's in there.
Harris, outlet pass.
Wow.
Save.
Whoa.
Count it.
Did you see that?
Brown.
We can't be possibly seeing the same thing right now.
Man.
Wonderful move. Athleticism to the maximum.
33-30, a minute and 12 seconds left in the third quarter.
Oh, and a loose ball is out of bounds. North Lawndale slipping up right now on offense. It's not looking too good. Got a little momentum behind the Lou Wallace team right now, man. They was definitely completing and executing, making everything fall in place. And North Lawndale just a careless turnover, as you just seen. Can't be affording those.
Harris brings it up. Kicks it in the corner.
Wide open look. Wonderful look. Just couldn't complete it. Sometimes players are too open.
Brown snatches the rebounds and scores.
Brown, man. 23 Brown.
Great
and
steal.
Lou Wallace. The whole team is in the game right now. They're in the zone. Unless North Lundell do something quick, I don't see anything happening. As Jones couldn't communicate back.
Brown brings it up. Passes it to number 11, the void. Swings it to Harris. Penetrates.
Whoa, great the no look pass into the inside. What a move.
Number 34, Brown.
That's right, man. The Brown brothers out here doing their thing. Look at the defense. Lou Wallace is definitely putting the pressure on tonight. The lead all passes up. No shot. The foul is on the ground. That'll be it for the third quarter, ladies and gentlemen, as we'll be moving on to the next quarter. You want to go ahead and toss us to a quick break?
We're going to toss us to a quick break. You're watching Hoops High.
Watching Hoops High.
Watching Hoops High.
General Styles, you see he puts it off with the backboard. I didn't even see him shoot it, but I see it go in and it counts. What you look like that for, man?
Because I do got to do next game.
That's why I just didn't mind. I don't mind. I got you for one next game, though. I'll give you a little play-by-play next game. Since you scratched my back, I scratch yours, you know. As you see North Lundell varsity and Lou Wallace varsity right now getting ready to go into the locker room, getting dressed. 6 minutes, 37 seconds on the clock right now, ladies. 34-35, North Lundell leads by one, and the ball is in their possession. That's like talking, like saying a lot of information at once. It sounds so wicked. Wicked. Cool, raw, something like that. Somewhere between those lines. Back to the game, though. Taylor breaking his man down defensively.
Man and man, Wallace.
Whoa, opened him up. The short 15-footer is good. Did you just see him, like, the crossover move? Like, it was like, man, strictly business. He's been working in the mirror for that for a long time, faking himself out. As the defense is evident, as Jones gets the rebound, the steal, goes up with a layup, no good.
Should have passed it. Runs to the camera people once again.
Told y'all, we're not playing. Y'all going to watch these basketballs. We're going to stop coming to these games. Y'all was asking, y'all gonna take the game? Y'all gonna take the game? Nope. Y'all gonna hit us with the ball? We know it's not purposely, y'all.
Taylor,
man, he's such a control. He got, like, the game in his own control, you know. The shooter, Jones, just haven't been hitting his mark today. He hit, like, one, I think, out of all of his shots. Was just not his style. You know, we used to see him in rare form when it comes to the shooting game. And today is just not that day. Sadly to say.
Gets it past half court.
Ball over to Harris. Harris at the three-point line. Kicks it in to Brown. Brown with the shot. It's good. Wonderful shot laid down by Brown. That was a nice short, about 12-footer. Doing a wonderful job right now. She can shoot the rock on demand. Taylor once again with the floor, controlling everything that's going down. Quick pick. Pick and roll. There's another pick and roll. Williams can't get the ball. He's knocked down. I think we got a foul on the play.
Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize about the missed interview. We had some technical difficulties. We know we are not always perfect. We are working hard, and we are always learning. We thank you for your support and encouragement.
You're watching us, baby. So what you see is what you get. What you see is what you get. That's more of his stuff. I don't really say that much. You know what I'm saying? Easy. With the small push, Brown is still completing, man. Brown has been just executing every play. I mean, as far as a one-on-one game, he's been doing his thing. Definitely a top-of-the-line player with the length that he has, and the shots he's been making, that's a D1 style, you know, a D1 model right there.
That's, he's very big threat.
Whoa.
Posting seamless.
Whoa.
Count that bucket.
Yeah.
39 to 38, 1-point lead. North Line.
Oh, we got goaltender. Definitely. Williams, you grabbed the rim. Grabbed that rim. It was obvious. I mean, you don't know why he's looking like that. I know he felt himself grab the rim. Oh, did they tackle?
Subs coming in.
Yeah. Definitely. Williams grabbed the ball on that play. Don't know what was going on, but.
Jones getting ready to inbound for North Lawndale. Officials getting everything situated.
I don't know what's going on, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry about that long pause. Welcome back.
Jones gets it back.
Pushes the ball up court with a lot of speed and agility. We got a block. The guy took the hit but just didn't fall down. Yeah, I don't know. It's a little backwards. Like, usually if you're going to stand in front of the ball, you should be falling, right?
Right.
I don't know what that was about. Going to the line for two shots. Jones at the line.
Getting ready to go off for his first shot. Count it.
You can always count those free throws. I mean, he's a wonderful shooter. Just today hasn't been his day. I mean, he usually hits the mark at all times, especially when he's open. Just not today. Going back to the line for the next shot.
Jones. Converted on the first one. Can he complete the second one? No good.
No
Brown
good at all.
Grabs the rebound. The void gives it to Harris.
Harris doing a wonderful job. Also, whoa.
Whoa.
I quit.
Man.
I quit. That was a wonderful, fantastic display of versatility. As a young and a small, not young, let me not say young, but as a small guy on his side, you never expect him to get in the hole, penetrate first off, and then make moves like that, and then complete with no, like, and just... Absolutely avoiding all contact and just completion. That was wonderful, man. 3:50 on the clock right now. 40-42. Lou Wallace leads by two. The lead's been switching. There it goes, ladies and gentlemen. Look, whoa. You can't even. Oh, my God. I don't want to commentate on top of that. Make it look bad.
Great play. Timeout was called. With that said, we're going to take a quick commercial break and watch the hoops on.
There are 63 gangs just in Chicago. Every day, young people in our neighborhood have to decide whether or not they're going to represent their hood or live a positive life. You can help yourself by staying in school, doing extracurricular activities, keeping yourself from gang-related activities, and being around positive people who are great role models.
It's in your hands. Be prepared and make the right choice.
Yes, yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are back. Coming out of a timeout.
How y'all like the game, ladies and gentlemen? I know it's exhilarating right now. Y'all like, oh, my God, well, how did I miss this? Well, if you hear, you like, man, I remember that. Like, man, just bring you back. And Hoops High, we do it. Glad y'all watching. Just tuning in. Lou Wallace now leads by 2 points as North Lawndale struggles to get their lead back. It's 3 minutes on the clock, 42 seconds and running. And North Lawndale has the ball. We got a wide open Jaquez Jones. No good. No good. Hopefully he'll get that. He'll get it working before the 2 minute mark or something, or after the 2 minute mark. But whenever you get it working, it's a sight to see, ladies and gentlemen. It's automatic.
Sooner the better.
Yes, definitely.
Loose ball comes up with it. North Lawndale.
Out to Thorpe. Thorpe can't hit the mark.
DeVort.
Got a wide open. Fast breaking Lou Wallace right now. Just moving the ball, takes the hit, and the foul is up. That was by Thorpe. Go to the line. Harris will be shooting two baskets.
Lou Wallace has great communication to make those types of passes that they complete.
Definitely.
Starts with communication, and when you communicate well, those type of passes complete get completed.
Yeah, I mean, completed passes equal open players with equal points.
Exactly.
Everything falls in place.
Which equals 42 to 40, Mark.
That's right. And possibly 43, right? Oh, not quite.
Failed us.
It's good. He going back to the line on this one. Hopefully he can make it up for me. Don't let me down, brother.
Harris takes his time. Second one is good. 43-40. Jones gives it to Taylor.
See, Thorpe caught up in the corner right now. I don't know if Lundell try to get this plan together, what they're going to do next. I mean, the 1-2-2 zone, which is basically the 3-2 zone, is looking pretty good for Lou Wallace. I mean, they don't really have a reason to move holding the league right now. They're pretty dominant in what goes down on their end of the court defensively. Be ready to inbound the ball.
Thorpe.
You got the spectators in the stands doing what they do. Oh, I don't know what went wrong there, but Lou Wallace should have had a trap. There's no way you got two guys that's standing in front of a guy in a corner and there's no trap.
Exactly.
Like, that was like a reverse trap because he went right past him, went to the free throw line with 2 points on top of that, man. Like, that's totally not the thing to do. Go to the line for his one shot.
Completes it.
It's all good.
3-point play. Harris floor zoner for Luol. Excuse me, Lou Wallace. Oh, hustles for it. Great move.
Nothing like hustle plays, man. This is where the blood and the sweat come from. You know, the tears come after the game is over.
Once again, spectators shouting that red defense.
Oh, easy. That red defense was not designed for that.
Exactly. Lazy. Very lazy play.
That's right, man. 43-45. Lou Wallace is back in the mix, ladies and gentlemen. What we've seen as a 13-point lead now is a 2-point lead on behalf of Lou Wallace.
Airball.
And they get another fast break. And he's gone. It's good. Ladies and gentlemen, Lou Wallace is now taking off in this game. 47-43. 4-point lead. They're opening up on North Lundell. And there's no timeout being called or anything like that.
Man, very, very needed timeout should be called.
That's right. In the most need of a timeout.
Exactly. Just 2 minutes left.
Oh.
Fourth quarter. Shot good.
Wonderful move to fake out. Perfect. Brandon Thorpe get it 45-47. North Lundell now leads by 2 points. Trails by 2 points.
Oh.
As you have the fast break. Jones. So Williams gets the foul. And looks like he'll be going to the line for 2 points. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have said it many times before. As you can see in the replay, there's that up fake and that smooth shot by Brandon Thorpe. But like we were saying, ladies and gentlemen, this is where it comes down to. No good. No good, ladies and gentlemen. This is not what you want. If the free throws in the beginning goes down, as they should anyway, you wouldn't be in this predicament. But since you are, you want to hit your free throws.
Crunch time, and you can't crack under pressure.
Oh, two. Back to back. And another fast break by Lou Wallace. This is 3-on-1, and we get a
offensive.
Oh, yeah, that's what it looks like, an offensive. I was going to say a foul. He was out of control. He had two other guys with him. A quick pass off to the left or the right would have made it happen.
Looks like it was a blocker foul, Mark.
Okay, then I understand. Why was the ref pointing the other way? All right, he's confusing us.
Inbound, Harris.
They can't go all the way back. Timeout for Lou Wallace. And ladies and gentlemen, with that being said, we want to take a quick timeout here. Hoops High. It's Mark Hill alongside Rafael Morales and watching Hoops High.
I'm gonna kill this nigga. I'm on my way, so meet me at the spot. Man, if I kill him, could I end up dead? Or could I get arrested? Nah, I won't kill him. It's not worth it.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Just tuning in, fourth quarter.
The sixth is coming down to the wire. It's like either go hard or go home. You know, big guys.
Crunch time.
Exactly. The big guys couldn't do what they was there to do now. Free throws miss, incomplete layups. And Lou Wallace has just been doing everything necessary to get the lead back because they lead by 2 points.
DeVoy
with the cut, just cut a little too quick.
It's Taylor coming in the game. 15 Jones, excuse me. Yeah, 15 Jones leaving out. It's Taylor brings it up.
Oh.
Good defense.
He got the kick right into the stands. Of North Lawndale.
That's good by Brown to be alert and ready for.
Yeah, I mean, he just
for kicked, steal.
High kick Rayon right in his mouth. I don't know if that much alertness is necessary. I mean, I'm just saying.
Everybody got to be alert.
Yeah, something you want to watch for.
Jones.
Oh.
Kicks it out to Taylor.
The cut is good. I mean, the fact is that they're in a 3-2 zone, so moving around wouldn't make a difference, you know. It's all about getting inside and drawing those fouls. We got 58 seconds on the clock right now, ladies and gentlemen. This is the fourth quarter. And I hope you're ready to enjoy this next game that we got coming up for you because it's something huge. Next Saturday, of course. But this game is going to be big. As you see here, I mean, the game is tight, and it's just Farsoft, JV, or whatever you want to call it, but there's more to come.
Harris trying to take Jones. Jones not going anywhere. Oh, reach around him, try to get a steal, ends up with a foul. Good call by the officials. This crowd's just very into this game.
Very into this game. I mean, who wouldn't be? Anybody just sitting there watching it and know they can't do anything about it, I'll be all up into it too.
I see the coach for Wallace having a chat with his players.
More than a chat, I feel.
Harris at the line. They're in a bonus.
First
shot is no good.
It's ridiculous.
Timeout was called. 44.7 seconds left in this game.
That's
47
right.
To 45.
Trying to devise some kind of last-minute plan, man. They need something if they plan on, you know, getting this game in the pocket as they hopefully want to do. I mean, who want to lose, like, in a game where you had a 13-point lead? Nobody.
That's right. Ladies and gentlemen, Hoopside is a flagship program of Free Spirit Media and is running a partnership with After School Matters, the Chicago Public Schools, and CAN TV. This is a team effort all around, and we are grateful for our partners who make this possible. With that said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick commercial break. You're watching Hoops High. Welcome back out of a timeout. 44.7 seconds remaining in his fourth quarter. 47-45. Very, very intense game. Wallace holds a 2-point lead.
That's right. And the possession is in North Lawndale's hands. You can hear behind us, ladies and gentlemen, the crowd is going crazy. North Lawndale holds what it looks like the final possession. And these guys, I think, want to get Jones open, even though he hasn't hit any shots. He's a wonderful shooter. The shot is up by Taylor. The shot is up by Taylor. Yeah, you can count that one. Everybody standing up right now. See if Lou Wallace going to rebuttal. Lou Wallace moves.
They are moving, ladies and gentlemen. The small guy can't get it. Oh, we have a foul on the play, ladies and gentlemen. And this is the North Lawndale's possession. 12 seconds on the clock.
Brown picks up a foul.
That's right. That's the wrong thing to do, right? The guy looked like he was rolling out of bounds almost. Got a 3-point, got a 1-point lead. And he pushes him out of bounds. So, I mean, I don't know what that was about.
Officials clearing things up with Lou Wallace's coach.
As you can hear, ladies and gentlemen, the chants are back and forth between both teams and both states and representatives of different places. As you see, we all come together and we all are alike, you know. And whatever we look different for, we come together in things and can all be one. You know, that's what it's all about right now, just seeing the unity. Even though we chanting against each other, I mean, it's for the same cause, you know, to get both teams winning.
Exactly.
And it's televised here, baby, hoops high. We do it the best. That's why we hoops high, baby, double H. This H double, all you other high school rap shows in trouble, you dig?
12 seconds left in this fourth quarter, 48-47. North Lawndale with a 1-point lead. Taylor earlier.
And should we stop talking?
Hit a 3-pointer, not at all. We can't toss it to a break. We can't do none of that.
Nah.
We can't let them be that anxious.
We won't be doing any of that. Nah. Not here. Not on Hoops High, not right now. Oh, my God. I just licked my lips, but I touched the microphone. That's nasty. And here we go. North Lawndale, 12.0 seconds on the clock. One possession, one game. 1 point can change everything. Can make the game out of reach. It can bring the game within the game. That can be it. And there's the foul, as expected.
Tater's going to go to the line shooting two. Well, shooting one, if he hit the first one, then he will be has a chance to hit another one.
That's right.
Bonus situation. Taylor getting ready to go off for his first shot that can change the game.
He needs both of those. He gets it.
Count it.
First shot is good. He needs both of those as he get ready for the second one. Can close the game out. You know, you make it can make it just a tight game. You don't have to worry about the game being over with and losing, or you know, just really bring it as far as out of reach as possible. And make it a 3-point play. Oh, he misses one. Foul, 8 seconds on the clock. He's going back to the line. Back to the line. With 8.7 seconds, Lou Wallace is not letting this game go out of their reach. They're going to do everything that's necessary as they have done already. And, I mean, even if the game is out of reach, I think they still fight for it. This is how much of a fighting team they are.
Exactly, not gonna stop fighting to this 0.0 seconds on the clock, and he knocks down the first one.
That's right.
50-47 is your score.
And that's exactly what is needed. One more point can put the game out of reach, or it can bring the game back within reach. It all counts on this one shot. Oh.
Is that counting?
4-point game, ladies and gentlemen.
Crunch time for Lou Wallace to come out after this timeout and just, man,
defense
and offense has to be on point. I would expect a quick three, but
I see the quick three or the quick two.
Exactly.
Back to back. Or the quick two and the foul is what you was going,
most
right?
Most likely.
Yeah, definitely. I understand that.
See some great crowd shots.
Right. You see the girls is fired up like crazy.
As the Wallace in the huddle has to be just talking about, you know, this last play that can make them or break them.
They is really dancing. Look at that. Doing their thing. North Lawndale's just so fired up right now.
Just 8 seconds on the clock as they get ready to come out of this timeout. Lou Wallace's possession.
Getting ready, man. I don't know what to do. Like, I don't know what to expect, truthfully. Didn't expect Lou Wallace to get this far in the game.
Not at all. But they're the underdogs, and this is what you expect.
I mean, they are rated number two, man, in Indiana. Like, and I believe they won City up in Gary, so. Exactly. Like,
not underdogs.
I don't know what to say. Oh, the little guy can't complete the three ball.
Number 34, Brown, couldn't complete it. Quick shot, and I mean, he was wide open. He had enough time to, you know, settle.
Actually, look.
Exactly.
There's 3 seconds left. And it looks like it's going to be over for Lou Wallace. He goes to the line for his two. They're going to close it on out. Let it ride out, ladies and gentlemen.
Clark at the line. Bonus situation. Hopefully he hits the first one so he has a chance to hit the second one.
Do you know what that means? That's 3 points. That's 3 points. They're going back to the drawing board.
As Lou Wallace's coach calls a timeout.
Man.
Talk things over.
Didn't expect that. I did not expect that. The game is not over, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you stay in tune right now because this is a big one. It's only JV, but it's still a big one.
Ladies and gentlemen, the PSAs, documentaries, and dramas that you see between breaks on Hoops High are produced by Free Spirit Media students at NLCP. We hope that you enjoy the stories and messages that we young people are sharing. That said, we're going to get ready to get back in this.
He about to say get ready to talk to a commercial break.
Man.
I feel you. Way to transition. Way to transition, Ralph. It's all good, man.
You see how I just changed it
up? That's how you do it. Exactly. That shows his experience, ladies and gentlemen. The way he just gone ahead and so smooth, elegant. He should be on smooth jazz with them kind of vocals. Telling y'all, ladies, y'all don't know about him. Y'all don't know about him, y'all. Y'all better get up to it as he go to the line for the second shot. It may be a miss on purpose, like a T-Mac kind of style. Yeah. Get it to the side, shoot that tray, tie it up. Oh, my God, not another one.
This time it's Duff Lindell's coach.
That's right. And now you can do it. You can do what you was going to do.
Let us toss it to a quick commercial break. You're out the hoop side.
I want to fight.
I need a fight.
They got to fight.
We got to fight.
Or do you? School violence only causes more problems. It can end with punishment or injury. So why fight? Let's all end school violence.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's Flap. Oops. It's Mark Hill. And I'm here with Rafael Morales on this wonderful night, spectacular night at Collins Campus, Hoops High. It's a wonderful day. As we're at the line for 2 free throws. Well, one. And he misses it. And that might be the end of the game. As we got a save, it's in the air. And it's a wrap. And it's over. And it's over. And it's over. And it's over. And it's over.
51-48, final score.
And it's a wrap. Anything you got to say, sir, about this wonderful, magnificent game we have witnessed tonight? We got to get an announcer now. Any game, anything you want to say? You want to?
We just want to thank everybody for watching.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for watching Hoops High. You are such wonderful, beautiful, wonderful people. And I bet you pay off your taxes. And I bet you do what God, Jesus do and all that good stuff. And I hope y'all voted for Obama because he's in office, whether you like it or not. I hope y'all didn't impeach Blagojevich, but he did get impeached, but he was a good guy.
He go.
Hey, we do it big, man.
Hey. With that said, we're going to toss to Jimmy. See what Jimmy got for us.
Hi, my name is Jimmy Love. I'm here with one of the players from New Wallace. What's your name, sir?
Devontae Harris.
Devontae Harris, man. I seen y'all playing. Y'all was doing y'all thing. Y'all, man, y'all did a lot to come back. Cause I mean, it looked like it was a real close win. So I mean, you got any shout outs to anybody, anything like that?
Nah, y'all just stay tuned. And watch this next game.
Well, go ahead, man. Go get back there, get dressed. So we got one more player. So what's your name, sir?
Garrett Taylor.
Garrett Taylor from the North Lyndale Phoenix, man. I saw you doing y'all thing, man. Y'all came back with a win. That was a crazy game, yo. So you got any shout-outs or anything like that?
I just wait for the next game.
Wait for the next game? You play next game?
Yeah.
You play next game? All right, so wait for next game, y'all. All right, go ahead and get dressed, big boy. All right, so you're watching Hoops High. Be sure to tune in every Saturday right here at 8 o'clock. Get out of here.
You can watch Hoops High on CAN TV Channel 19 every Saturday at 8 p.m. Please visit www.hoopshigh.org to learn more.
Hoops High and Free Spirit Media would like to thank our sponsors, Aero Capital Management and Aerial Mutual Funds, and the Kraft Employee Fund. We are grateful for their support, making our mission of youth media education and opportunity possible.
Kanye and that twister shit. That's so impossible to get it. Get it? That's so impossible to get it. Get it? That's so impossible to get it. Get it? Roto up then lit it. Smoke a little but don't admit it. Do it like I did too late. I did it. The controversy can't worse me, man. I'm eating but I'm still thirsty. And thirsty, what did you saying? I got into it with a couple of niggas last Thursday, man. Why the hell is I'm worried? I've been at the bins with the perfect 10. Man, your life must be perfect, man. Look at how they came up with the perfect plan. It's impossible. Got strip clubs playing gospel. Flow so sick in the hospital. You know I jap out like Pac a do. You know you throw your diamonds when I rock with you. Since Michael Jackson made rock with you, I think it's just unlogical. Maybe because we did the impossible. Maybe we did the impossible.
They probably never was exposed to it. They probably would have never have done it, but it's something that you see that interests people a lot.
I never worked with a camera. You know, it was my first time learning about a camera, you know, zooming in, zooming out. It was real good experience for me. You know, I think it changed a lot in me too. It changed my how I think, and it changed like some I like to do in life.
When I get older, I want to be some type of actor. So being in this classroom really helped me out, really exercised my ability to act.
We shooting it and we shoot it off like what we done been through, and like people get to see it and they watching it and they liking it.
Like young kids in the community can do stuff that's like worth some type of value.
Hey, what's up? Javonte Austin, high school sensation. You know, rookie in the NBA, and I'm still trying to get my high school diploma. I don't know what's wrong, man. It's just the league, they just need me they just want me in the NBA. I still ain't got my high school diploma. Well, for now, y'all finna see how I work out and how I made it. The road to stardom.
Okay, so who can tell me anything about what we have here about relevance? Anybody?
Giovanni.
Reliability, relying on me, you know what I'm saying, to win the game, which they need to do.
Okay.
So allow me.
I see where you're going with that. And I think actually reliability talks about the author's ability to be a credible source. But I see what you're saying. I see you trying to take that to a different spectrum. And I like that. I think that's good.
Hi, we're once again with Gio Austin and North Lando College Prep. How's it going? How are you doing?
What's up, man? What's up?
So, how does it feel to be the NBA player trying to, you know, get his degree still?
What's up, baby? How y'all doing? But it's like, man, you know what I'm saying? I just been in high school, you know. Got this Nike deal, you know what I'm saying? Damn, I got this Nike deal. You know, Nike cleats coming to a store near you. You know what I'm saying? I got this Swag Nation deal, you know, for the casual, you know what I'm saying? You know, just trying to make it out, you know, do what I gotta do.
Giovanni, man, this man got like 20 TVs in the ride. I'm like, man, should I hop in there? It's a TV right in the steering wheel. Then the radio come from under the dashboard. I'm like, man, this man got TVs in the screen, in a float, in a windshield. Damn, it's crazy, man. He got so many TVs, it's unbelievable. He caked up, man.
So, it's like, damn, I knew my car was outside, but I don't know, I'm confused. I know I drove it to school, parked it, tossed the keys in the air, valet man caught it, but did he catch it? I don't know, man, but I'm rich. Rick James, no matter me. I'm rich, bitch!
Yeah, baby. I'm finna just go ahead and go to the league. So, skip school, man.
What you talking about? Skip school? What you gonna do? You have no backup plan.
I'm gonna start in the league right now, man. You know? I ain't skip the school, man. I'm rich. I'm richer than everybody in the school.
Okay. And then what? You have no backup plan. Hey. What if something happens?
You know, I can't believe what I'm hearing. Giovanni Austin is talking about leaving high school, going directly into the NBA. First of all, his education comes first. Now, of course, he's dumb in school. Well, I shouldn't use that word dumb, but he is kind of slow. But he's even slower if he think that he can go straight to the NBA and bypass high school, bypass college. He knows how important his education is. He knows how his mother feels about it. He knows how his father feels about it. And he knows how I feel about it as a mentor and as a coach. This is ridiculous. I can't believe he's even thinking about it. I tell you what, he better get that out of his head right now. He's a very talented player, don't get me wrong, but education comes first.
I'll miss everybody. You know, the women, of course. Some of the teachers, like, you know, the gym teacher, lunch teachers, you know, them. I miss all of them.
Oh, it's the reason.
I got this game to play the Bulls tonight in my hometown. Yeah, I'm ready. I'm gonna play against Rose, and I'm gonna show them what I'm about. Show them, man, how I get down. That's right. Yeah, man. Oh, I injured my leg, man. Doc said I might be out for 2-3 months. I don't know what I'm gonna do, man. I don't know, man. I'm going to the doctor immediately, though. All right?
Thank you.
In the perspectives of teens in Chicago newsroom, great ideas are being formed about their future. For some of these teens, it's their first time as voters, and it happens to be a historical presidential election.
I would say I was really nervous because I didn't want to make the wrong decision.
Hundreds of years ago, they didn't have that same right. So now that we do have the chance, we should take advantage of it.
I decided to come out tonight to a polling site. With under an hour left until polls close, there are a lot of youth out here tonight that can't vote, but they have a lot to say about it.
I think everybody should have a voice in, you know, the election.
People underestimate us for being younger, but we know what we want, and we know what's good for our health and our well-being. So I think we should be able to vote.
It's important that I should have a say so in the election because whoever the people who can vote elect is going to affect everyone, grown people and children.
Some organizations, such as the National Youth Rights Association, are trying to lower the voting age to 16. Some of you think this is a great idea.
Just because we, like, not old enough to vote, that don't mean we won't make the right choice. 16 is good and all, but why they can't make it younger? They saying, like, 16 are more mature.
This is a decision that affects everyone, and ultimately, adults will have the final say.
What's left over of the resources will end up in your laps anyway.
I could say they could, but I wouldn't go no younger than 16.
When the next presidential election rolls around, many of these middle school students will be of voting age. It seems as if they are getting an early start on their political agendas. I'm Savashine Brown for Perspectives of Teens in Chicago.
I'm finna go to the store. You want something?
No. Come here.
You want something to sell? Mm-hmm. You want to eat? You want to eat?
Mm-hmm.
Want some chips?
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'll be back.
I can't go back.
Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. From home, away from home.
Mama, I mean, I know I did wrong, and I know I left her to do drugs, but I came back so she can at least respect me. I'm still her mama no matter what.
Tiffany, you've been gone for 15 years. You can't just expect her to forgive you right on the spot. She don't know who you is. You a stranger. You didn't take care of her. You left her when she was one. What you expect for her to say? It's not gonna be like you want it to be, how you think it should be.
Sometimes I feel like a motherless child.
Did you know that nearly 2,000 animal abuse cases occurred last year in the U.S.? And there are countless more occurring right now. Dogs like Rusty and Cookie deserve a better chance in life. We can come together to make a change. You wouldn't hurt the one you love. Make a change. Stop pet abuse.
Going to talk about the grades. Okay, I had just received the grades from last time, and it looks bad.
Man, Mr. Martin, it's the end of the trimester, man. We're not worried about no grades.
I got an A and Jim.
So we dumb.
You want to be like the rest of those dumb fools on standing on the corner, not doing nothing? I'm surprised they come to school. It's time to grow up, son.
So what, you want daddy now?
No, it's not being about your being the daddy. It's about being responsibility. Handle your responsibility.
All right.
Don't forget to study, people.
Who is it?
Marcus. Is David here?
Marcus, what do you want with David?
Can he come outside?
No, he can't. He has finals to study for, and you should be doing the same thing. He doesn't have time for this nonsense. He has a test on Monday, and him going outside with you to do nothing is not going to help.
It's not nonsense. Actually, it's positive.
Right. I believe you.
Hey, what's up, Marcus?
What's up, dude? Hey, you ready?
No, he's not ready. And he's not gonna be ready. You, go study.
Come on, Dad, I'm in high school now. Why are you treating me like a kid?
Because you have to study.
Can I at least go on the front porch?
David, you got 5 minutes. Hey, you hear me? 5 minutes.
Yes, sir.
Thanks, sir. So, what's up?
Let's go.
What you talking about, let's go?
Let's hit the road.
Hey, wait. So you mean to tell me that you're gonna leave?
Come on.
Your dad's gonna knock your butt out, dude.
Look out long enough. What are you gonna do anyway?
I'm gonna blow up off my dad.
Hell no.
Yeah.
All right, y'all. Nah, he just playing. Brito, we just gonna break it off Londale. Probably messing around and playing and stuff. That's all. Yeah, we gotta get out. Since Dad be tripping.
Yeah.
Come on, y'all, let's just go before it gets too late.
David! David! You seen David? I knew I shouldn't let that boy go out.
Man, I got
Okay, you stay right here. Can I go pee?
Thank you.